Incredibly useful and durable toothpick.
Snow dog.
Yo, I'm gonna wallpaper my room. Black trash bags.
Black trash bags. That's classy. Make sure you spray paint B-Rock across it. Your mama loved that one. Here's some more nonstop help me, I'm unemployed rock.
Tommy, man, am I glad to see you.
What's going on?
Bad vibes, Tommy.
Aye, I'm nae joking again. It's heavy stuff, man. Heavy gang.
This cat, we hardly know him, but he knows us. Like this cat. Knows all about us. Knows that Willie likes his ladies' underwear, eh? Or that Percy likes
Duran Duran. Shut up, you fool. Just jazz bomb sheep. It's a love rocket thing, can.
Shut up. Yeah, a love rocket thing, right? But listen, this cat.
The guy who wants Love Fist dead. Dead, Tommy. Love Fist, gone. You know what they say, the good die young, but Tommy, you've got to save Love
Fist. We've got a signing in 2 hours, and I think...
Yeah, and the boys think the stalker's going to try some monkey business there.
The American way, in a theme park. And that's just the kind of person I am, opinionated and moronic.
I see. Well, this panel is certainly interesting. The issue is morality. Recently, rock artists joined together to provide famine aid to Alaska with the song, Do They Know It's the 4th of July? Critics complain it's immoral to meddle in the affairs of other peoples and cultures. Pastor Richards...
What?
I'll see Love Fist burn. Love Fist ruined my life.
...an over-opinionated sociopath.
Well, let me say that money could have gone to much better things, like reserving a place by my side in the Pastor Richard Salvation statue. But I digress and plug.
Stop doing
that. Don't interrupt me, boy. Anywho, I address the Alaska issue in chapter 23 of my book. You see, the Alaskans are lunatics, plain and simple. They eat whale and snow and asleep in the freezer. Who wants to eat snow every day? Oh, I tried to help. I sent a helicopter with copies of my book, but they burned them in a pile for heat. If the people of Alaska choose to live there, let them. But don't come crying when you're tired of eating penguin and it snows 18 feet a day.
Yes, but don't you think it's important?
I think it's very important to listen to me, young man. That's what makes the state of Florida great. Rather than help improve where they are, people nationwide abandon their hometowns, come down here, and shove their beliefs down everyone else's throats. That's the American way, always has been. We should send some pictures of Florida to those people in Alaska. I tell you, they throw down that bear pelt, saddle up the sled dogs, and get pulled all the way to Vice City. And I should know, I'm from Mars.
No, you're not.
Mars, Alabama. I found it.
The problem with Alaska is that people don't get naked. If you can't work on your car, or play the cello, or use sharp knives in your birthday suit, then what's the point of living?
Well, it is a bit cold there. People put on clothes when it's cold. We evolved without a warm covering of them.
The rip-off, man!
Catch FM.
Start your own radio station. It's easy.
Starfish Island. Any takers?
For 3 days.
Tommy here, I'll take it.
Thanksgiving quickly became an annual custom. America was founded by people who wanted a place where they could tell other people how to live. And I'm a history major. But do we have the right? The question, is it moral to celebrate Thanksgiving, a holiday that is clearly about gluttony, annoying relatives, and awful casserole?
Well, I for one love a casserole. And at my weekly meeting, my congregation has a potluck. You see, a casserole is a lot like life, Maurice, and that's the basis of my philosophy. If you put a bunch of leftovers from the fridge in a pan and bake it, somebody will probably eat it. It's like my book. You believe in your favorite sports team, then they get massacred. You believe in gravity, then it turns upside down on you. You love your favorite TV show, then the network ends it with a lousy finale. But you can believe in me, and if you believe in something, support it. It's one thing to love something, but if you don't shower it with money, then just don't talk to me. Communism, don't make me...
It's on Thanksgiving. And the way to teach your children the rich history of America is through theme parks. I just love Pilgrim World.
This is my fair. Back off, asshole.
And take home the meat, or give the locals the flu while buying their land off them for a pittance. That's what children need.
What is?
Wholesome activities that benefit the family. Now, what good is it if a kid plays Degeneratron for 5 hours? Oh, sure, he's killing space aliens, thank you very much, but it ain't putting food on the table. And he's learning bad language, like... When my family go out to dinner, we're starting from scratch, even if Daddy is working late again. We build our own spears, smear ourselves in dung, and then wait in a swamp for something to come by.
In the suburbs? I bet your neighbors love you. How long do you wait? Don't you get arrested?
Hey, mister, I'm married. Look at the finger. It has a ring. I've got children, for Pete's sake. Stop eyeing me up.
I wasn't.
You were. I can see you undressing me with your eyes. Well, I tell you, I was a cheerleader and nearly a prom queen. And I could have married anyone, but I chose John. I chose him because he had a kind face and a rich dad. I didn't know he was going to cheat on me or embarrass me. I didn't know. But I won't be made a fool of. I've got the children.
Okay, Jan. It's okay. Men are idiots. Ask my ex-wife. Don't worry. Stay calm. I'm not eyeing you up, but I am a little worried about you. How are the children? Will they enjoy
precisely why I'm going to start homeschooling my children. High school is a cult. There's a group of savages that rule the roost and get all the girls, and everyone else is picked on and abused. It happened to me, and look at me. I'm a deranged mess, and my husband cheats on me. I don't want my kids to go to a public high school. Instead, we have a prom each year in my living room.
And that leads to my next question.
People in high school in Chile are all naked.
I've about had it with you, Barry. I try to be fair, I try to be kind, but you are a freak and a liar and wasting everybody's time. The organs below the belt are for reproduction and removing of bodily waste. There's no reason that when I go to buy a soda or a transmission, I need to be distracted by your privates dangling about. Now, when I go to the store to buy an air conditioning filter, I'd rather not have to look at your moneymaker, amigo. I'm glad you are proud of it. But when people of Vice City are in a quick... Come on, get in, quick. Have a simple fine...
Okay. Please, don't hurt me.
Are you with me?
Sorry, Maurice.
That's okay. Just try to behave. I think the sun must have got to you or something.
Yes, maybe that's it.
Maurice, if I may, you have a fine show here, and I'm glad to be on it. But everyone within the sound of my voice and smell will die in the fires of doom. It is written. State to play golf, and I'll be damned if any weirdo hippies are going to tell us we can't fill in wetlands and make a home for ourselves, complete with 18-hole championship standard courses and selective admission. Heathens will ruin the land. Acid will rain from the skies. We'll never hear my voice again. It will be anarchy.
TV teaches immorality. Refugees, glue, the price of tea in China. How can we raise children in this environment? My little boy asked me the other day, Mommy, are unicorns real? What am I supposed to say to that? Do I lie and make myself as bad as the boy's father? Or do I break the little boy's heart and ruin his life so that he ends up a nudist or a freak or something?
It's a difficult question, Jack. Very difficult question. Is it right to lie?
Clothes are a lie, Maurice.
No, Barry. Clothes are a way of keeping warm and not getting arrested.
No policeman has ever hit me with his truncheon.
I'd like to hit you back to hell, you sicko. You're filth. Human form of vermin. A blight on a fine society picket fences and garden parties, and everyone coming three times a day to my statue to pay homage.
Pastor Richards, as a human being, I have to say I find your philosophy or cult or whatever it is utterly and completely appalling.
Why, thank you. I knew you'd understand.
I mean, you seem to want to build a religion around yourself and some 1950s vision of America. It's the 1980s, man! And one-man worship me cults are not allowed, my friend.
Exactly. As I say in the great book, many are called, but unless you have a good credit rating, go screw yourself. You'll burn in hell.
Ay, por favor, shut up. But Barry, what are you doing?
I'm lonely, Maurice. Lonely, and I need some bodily contact.
Get behind. Get back behind that panel.
Don't be shy. Please. We've all got one. That means I'm happy.
Hey, stay away from me. I'm a celebrity.
Oh, good Lord.
Hide yourself, boy. I warn you, I'm armed and I'm not afraid to use it.
We've all got one. Look how free I am. Mmm. Fan feels so good. I feel you.
Hey, Pastor Richards, please put the gun away. Put it away.
No. I am the sole judge of truth and decency. Get back, heathen. Get back.
I love you all.
Evildoer, die, devil. Die.
Ow.
Dios mío, you shot him. There's blood and pubic hair all over the studio. Ladies and gentlemen, it is complete pandemonium here on Pressing Issues with me, the multi-award-winning and soon-to-be-executed Maurice Chavez. Barry? Are you okay? Are you alive?
Stop the bleeding. It's down there.
Oh.